Hello students, today I am going to take up the topic lesson planning for B.Ed class. Before planning a lesson, our teacher should be very clear that what type of approach and what type of method we are using in this lesson. Today what we have taken up, the approach is teacher-centered approach and the steps are or the method is lecture demonstration method. The steps for lecture demonstration method were given by a German philosopher named Herbert. So the steps are called Herbertian steps of lesson planning. The steps include number one, preparation, then presentation, association, then generalization and application. So first step, that is preparation. Preparation is done before going to the class. While a teacher is preparing for the lesson, she has to keep in mind certain things. First of all, it is the subject matter. That is the content, means what you are going to teach. That should be very much into your mind. And because that is the thing which you have to plan, that how to convey the things. And second is teaching aids. Teaching aids means the aids, the material which you are using to illustrate your teaching. Like you can be using computer with images, PPTs, videos, etc. Or it can be some model working or still, or it can be real objects like in science. Generally we use real objects. And then you have to see that what is the duration of your period. Can it be 30, 40, 50 or whatever it is. And very important is that you have to plan the lesson. Lesson is generally planned in a written illustrious form. And if you are a beginner, then it will be elaborated lesson plan, to which we call macro lesson plan. And if you are a practicing teacher, then the macro lesson is planned in a diary format. The lesson plan, the elaborated form of lesson plan, I'm going to teach you now, in the which is coming in the first step, and that is macro lesson plan. For macro lesson plan, first of all, you have to write your roll number, the class which you are going to teach, your subject and the topic which you are going to teach on the right side of your copy or the plan over here. And then comes the specific aids, which are very particular for that topic. Like for magnetism or magnet, the specific aids which you need, these are like magnet, magnetic needle, iron pins, pencil box, coin, etc., that you will be writing here. And then expected behavioral outcomes are very simple. It's the objectives. Objectives, you all know that knowledge, understanding, application, skills, scientific attitude, all that we know that these are the objectives of teaching science. While you are teaching some particular topic, you have to change these objectives into behavioral terms. Like for magnet, in with respect to knowledge, first of all, knowledge. With respect to knowledge, how you will plan that what will be the expected behavioral outcome? It is that the students will be able to recall the concept of magnet-iron attraction. Then student will be able to know the history of discovery of magnet. He will know the types of magnet. He will be able to define the magnet. And then understanding. Understanding, like student is able to explain the properties of magnet. For application purpose, student will be able to find the applications of magnet in daily life based on the properties. In the application part, application objective, he will be able to conclude the facts from the evidences he has collected from his experiment. He will be able to solve the problems which are based on them. With respect to skills, because skills is also very important objective of teaching science. So for skill is that he will be able to have hands on some practice like making model or doing some drawing, etc. Scientific attitude, that which is the most important objective of teaching science. With respect to magnet, what we can say that he will accept the facts and the ideas which are based on evidence only. He will make the keen observation. He will not be superstitious. So you can add more sub-objectives to this. And then the interest. like developing interest, developing students' interest in science. Then you have to give the behavioral entry, behavioral assumed entry behavior. Means what you think, that what is this time, what is the knowledge of the student. To that we can say that for magnets, students already know that magnets have the attractive property. They have seen it somewhere that magnets can attract the things. Then entry behavior testing. Like how a teacher can do the entry behavior testing, that what is the level of the students. Generally, it's in three forms. One is the teacher is performing some activity and asking questions about that, or it can be narrating some incidents and